Hello everyone, welcome to the coding tuition. In this video we will see solution to the problem sparse arrays. It is a medium level problem. Let us first read the problem statement and then we will see different methods to get the solution. There is a collection of input strings and the collection of query strings. For each query string, determine how many times it occurs in the list of input strings and return the array of results. So we have an array of strings and also an array of queries. Now what we have to do, for every string in the queries array, we have to find the number of times that string occurs in the input string array. For example, here in the queries array we have the first string AB. Now we will count how many times does AB occurs in the strings array. So yahan pe AB occurs 2 times, so therefore the result for AB will be 2. Similarly for ABC, ABC occurs only one time in the strings array, so for ABC the answer will be 1, and for BC it doesn't occur in the strings array at all, so the answer will be 0. So we will return an array 2, 1, 0. Okay, so this is what the problem is. And one thing to note is there are n strings and q queries. Okay, now let's see different methods to get the solution. So the first method is the brute force approach. Okay, now what we have an array of strings. It contains 4 strings AB, BC, ABC and again AB, and we have a queries array. It contains 2 strings AB and ABC. Now what we have to do, the brute force approach is, for every string in the queries array we will traverse the whole string array once and we will find the count of that string in the strings array. For example, yahan pe queries ka first string is AB. Now we will, for AB we will traverse the strings array and we will see whether AB is present or not. So the first string is AB, make the count as 1, then the second string is BC, third string is ABC and the fourth string is again AB. So we will make the count as 2. Now for AB we have got the value as 2. Similarly for ABC, again we will traverse the whole string, right? So initially the count will be 0, then for since the string is AB which is not equal to ABC, then we will move to BC, then again we will move here we have the required string, so we will make the count as 1. This will be the result for the string ABC and we will return this array. But the issue with this problem is the time complexity. Since the number of strings in the queries are q and number of strings in the input string is n, the time complexity will be O of nq, because for every string we are traversing the whole strings array. So since there are q strings, we will traverse n into q times. So this will be the time complexity, and the space complexity will be O of 1. ठीक है, इतना क्लियर है. बट दिस अप्रोच इज नॉट एन एफिशिएंट अप्रोच. वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट मेथड दैट हाउ टू ऑप्टिमाइज दिस. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी द मेथड नंबर 2. सो हियर इज द सेकंड मेथड. इन द सेकंड मेथड वी विल बी यूजिंग मैप, राइट? इफ यू आर यूजिंग जावा देन यू कैन यूज हैश मैप, राइट? हैश मैप फॉर जावा. एंड इफ यू आर यूजिंग C++ देन मैप और अनऑर्डर्ड मैप. ठीक है, फॉर C++. Now let's see how to do that. We have a strings array and the queries array, right? What we will do, our first step is we will traverse the full strings array and we will store the count of each unique string into the hash map. For example, let us see how to do that. First we will create an hash map. Okay, now we will traverse the strings array. When we will encounter the first string, then we will check into the map whether the entry of AB is present. Now since the hash map is empty, the entry of AB is not there, what we will do, we will make the entry of AB and the count as 1, right? This means we have found the AB up till now and its count is 1. Then second, when we find BC, we will see whether BC is present in the map or not. Since BC is not present, what we will do, we will update the map with the entry of BC. We will write BC, 1 because we have found BC 1 times. Then again for ABC, we will make an entry for ABC, right? Now again when we found AB, we will check whether AB is present on the map or not. Yes, AB is present. What we will do, we will increment its count by 1. Initially the count was 1, now it will be 2. Now this will be a complete map. Okay, now the step 1 is complete. नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द स्टेप टू. ओके, स्टेप टू क्या होगा कि हम हर एक क्वेरी स्ट्रिंग में जाएंगे एंड वी विल सी व्हाट इज द काउंट ऑफ दैट स्ट्रिंग इनटू द ओरिजिनल इनपुट स्ट्रिंग. नाउ हियर द फर्स्ट स्ट्रिंग इन द क्वेरी इज ए बी. नाउ फॉर ए बी वी विल सी वेदर ए बी इज प्रेजेंट इन द हैश मैप और नॉट. इफ वी सी यस ए बी इज प्रेजेंट, नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू इज नाउ वी विल गेट द नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स ए बी इज रिपीटेड इन द ओरिजिनल स्ट्रिंग. सिंस द नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स इज 2, व्हाट वी विल गेट इज for AB the count is 2. Similarly for ABC we will see the hash map. Yes, ABC is present and its count is 1. So we will return an array 2, 1. Now suppose यहाँ पे एक और string होता PQ. Okay, so यहाँ पे हम check करेंगे in the hash map whether PQ is present or not. Since in the hash map PQ is not present, what we will do, the entry of PQ will be 0 and we will return the array 2, 1, 0. Okay, I hope this much is clear. This was the step 2. Now let us see what will be the time complexity. So the time complexity will be O of n for traversing the strings array, right? We will traverse the strings array once to make the hash map, then O of q to traverse the queries array. ठीक है, इतना क्लियर है. एंड द स्पेस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी विल बी ओ ऑफ एन बिकॉज वी आर क्रिएटिंग अ हैश मैप ऑफ साइज एन. ओके, एट मैक्स देर कैन बी एन यूनिक स्ट्रिंग्स, सो एट मैक्स द साइज ऑफ द हैश मैप कैन बी एन. ओके, एंड हियर इफ वी यूज सी प्लस प्लस वी विल यूज अनऑर्डर्ड मैप एंड द एवरेज ऑन द टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ अनऑर्डर्ड मैप इज ओ ऑफ 1. आई होप दिस मेथड इज क्लियर टू यू. नाउ लेट्स सी द कोड ऑफ इट. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव क्रिएटेड द अनऑर्डर्ड मैप विच विल स्टोर द काउंट ऑफ ईच यूनिक स्ट्रिंग इन द स्ट्रिंग्स एरे. नाउ वॉट वी आर डूइंग इज इन दिस फॉर लूप वी आर मेकिंग द एंट्री ऑफ ईच ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग्स इन आर हैश मैप. ठीक है, देन वी हैव डिक्लेयर्ड and vector result which will store the result in this for loop. We are traversing the queries array and for every query string what we are doing is we are finding whether that query is present or not. If that query is not present, then what unordered map will do is if we will check mp.find queries of I. If this queries of I is not present, then what unordered map will do is it will point to the end of the unordered map. So we are checking whether this find method is pointing us to the end of the map or not. If it is pointing to the end of the map, then we can conclude that the queries of I is not present and we will store the value as 0 into our result array. Else what we will do, we will get the value of that string from the hash map. Okay, in this way our result array will be created and in the end we will return the result. I hope this much is clear. Now let's submit the code. As you can see, all the test cases are cleared. And this was it regarding the video. If you found this video helpful, then do like this video. And please subscribe to the channel. And if you have any suggestions, please comment down below. Thank you for watching. Bye.